The purpose of this video is to show you how to change the auxiliary relay mode on the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency controller through the face of the controller. To start this process, you start at a home point, which is basically where the controller is showing the room temperature readout for the room temperature sensor. To make sure you're at this point, you can press the back button a couple of times to verify that you are at this position. From there, you can scroll right or left to the different columns until you see the Setpoints menu column. Once you're at that point, you can scroll up or down into that Setpoints column. If you've not entered your password at this point, it will prompt you to enter your password. Press the Enter key button one time. Change the value of each digit by pressing the up arrow button. Change the digit that you're highlighting by pressing the right or left arrow key. Once you have your password in place, press and hold the Enter button again for 3 seconds, and now you have access to the Setpoints column. From there, we're going to scroll down until we see auxiliary relay mode being displayed. Once you see that being scrolled across the display of the controller, you can press the Enter button to see exactly what mode it's set for right now, which in this case is the alarm relay mode. So it goes off when alarms go off. Again, we're going to change that value to be a two-speed evaporator fan control. So in order to change this value now, hold the Enter key button down for 3 seconds. At that point, you'll see that the red and amber LED lights are going to flash on you. From here, you can scroll up and down to see what the different options are available for this relay. You can see it can be a camera relay if you have the digital input connected to a switch or a door connection to turn on a camera. You could also turn on a light with that relay for the same function. You can also use it for a two-speed evaporator fan control, which is what we're going to use it for today. A couple of other options: if you have the defrost relay, the compressor relay, or main evaporator fan relay burn out for some reason or fail for some reason, you could use this auxiliary relay as a backup to one of those relays. So again, for our purpose today, we're going to use it as a second speed evaporator fan control. So once you have that scrolling across the display, press and hold the Enter key button down for 3 seconds. Now the red and amber LEDs will quit flashing, which tells me that now this mode has been set to the second speed fan control. From here, you can press the back button a couple of times, get you back to your home point where the temperature sensor shows the room readout. And that's the end of our process.
Thank you for viewing our video. If you have any questions or comments on the video or suggestions for future video topics, please contact us at www.ketotherm.com or by calling 636-266-0140.